of your favorite SiriusXM programming on demand with the SiriusXM app. Download it now for free.
I'm Frank Trachtenberg with your SiriusXM sports schedule for Saturday, March the 30th. All times are Eastern, and please remember, all games, times, and channels are subject to change. Check SiriusXM.com for the latest updates. In the NBA, 5 p.m., New Orleans Pelicans take on the Boston Celtics. Pelicans on SiriusXM channels 86, Internet 898, Celtics on Internet 881. 7 p.m., Orlando Magic take on the Memphis Grizzlies. Magic on Sirius 113, XM 212, and Internet 901. Grizzlies on Internet 894. 7:30 p.m. Atlanta Hawks take on the Milwaukee Bucks. Hawks on Sirius XM channels 86, Internet 880. Bucks on Internet 896. In the NHL, 4 p.m. Edmonton Oilers take on the Anaheim Ducks. Oilers on Sirius XM channels 91, Internet 931. Ducks on Internet 920. 6 p.m. Colorado Avalanche take on the Nashville Predators. Avalanche on XM 220, Internet 927. Predators on Internet 936. 6 p.m., Arizona Coyotes take on the New York Rangers. Coyotes on XM 223, Internet 921. Rangers on Internet 939. 7 p.m., Columbus Blue Jackets take on the Pittsburgh Penguins. Blue Jackets on XM 221, Internet 928. Penguins on Internet 942. 7 p.m., Montreal Canadiens take on the Carolina Hurricanes. Canadiens on XM 222, Internet 935. Hurricanes on Internet 925. 7 p.m., Winnipeg Jets face the Ottawa Senators. Jets on XM 206, Internet 951. Senators on Internet 940. 7 p.m., Buffalo Sabres take on the Toronto Maple Leafs. Sabres on Sirius and XM channels 91, Internet 923. Maple Leafs on Internet 947. 7 p.m., Washington Capitals take on the Boston Bruins. Capitals on XM 205, Internet 950. Bruins on Internet 922. 7 p.m., Tampa Bay Lightning take on the New York Islanders. Lightning on XM 207, Internet 946. Islanders on Internet 938. 7 p.m., Philadelphia Flyers take on the Chicago Blackhawks. Flyers on XM 203, Internet 941. Blackhawks on Internet 926. 8 p.m., St. Louis Blues take on the San Jose Sharks. Blues on XM 219, Internet 945. Sharks on Internet 943. 10 p.m., Calgary Flames take on the LA Kings. Flames on Sirius and XM channels 91, Internet 924. Kings on Internet 933. 10 p.m., Seattle Kraken face the Dallas Stars. Kraken on XM 223, Internet 944. Stars on Internet 929. In the UFL, 4 p.m., Michigan Panthers take on the St. Louis Battlehawks on Sirius XM and Internet channels 83. In NCAA college baseball, 4 p.m., Virginia Tech faces Pitt on XM and Internet 371. 4 p.m., West Virginia faces Oklahoma State on XM and Internet 375. 6 p.m., Ohio State faces Purdue on XM and Internet 372. 7 p.m., Wake Forest faces North Carolina on XM and Internet 371. 8 p.m., Texas A&M takes on Auburn on XM and Internet 374. In NCAA college women's basketball, 3:30 p.m., Iowa faces Colorado on Sirius 210, XM 203, and Internet 966. 5:30 p.m., USC faces Baylor on Sirius 211, XM 204, and Internet 967. 8 p.m., UConn faces Duke on Sirius 211, XM 204, and Internet 967. I'm Frank Trachtenberg with your SiriusXM sports schedule for Saturday, March the 30th. All times are Eastern, and please remember, all games, times, and channels are subject to change. Check SiriusXM.com for the latest updates. In the NBA, 5 p.m., New Orleans Pelicans take on the Boston Celtics. Pelicans on Sirius and XM channels 86, Internet 898. Celtics on Internet 881. 7 p.m., Orlando Magic take on the Memphis Grizzlies. Magic on Sirius 113, XM 212, and Internet 901. Grizzlies on Internet 894. 7:30 p.m., Atlanta Hawks take on the Milwaukee Bucks. Hawks on Sirius and XM channels 86, Internet 880. Bucks on Internet 896. In the NHL, 4 p.m., Edmonton Oilers take on the Anaheim Ducks. Oilers on Sirius and XM channels 91, Internet 931. Ducks on Internet 920. 6 p.m., Colorado Avalanche take on the Nashville Predators. Avalanche on XM 220, Internet 927. Predators on Internet 936.
The PGA Tour comes to life on SiriusXM. It's your destination for everything on the tour. Hear live hole-by-hole coverage and expert analysis. PGA Tour Radio, SiriusXM 92.
I'm Mick Kern with It Happened in Baseball. July 21st, 1953. Shibe Park in Philadelphia as the Phillies played host to the Milwaukee Braves. With the visitors down by 10 runs in the seventh inning, manager Charlie Grimm went to his bullpen and motioned for 17-year-old Joey Jay to take the mound. The native of Middletown, Connecticut was the leading edge of a new wave of baseball sweeping across America. New rules instituted in the late 40s mandated that young players signed to contracts had to remain with the big league club for the first 2 years of that deal, in an effort to make sure that the top clubs didn't scoop up all the top young talent and stash them away on their farm teams. This rule lasted until the late 50s and then was reinstituted during expansion in the early 60s. The adoption of the amateur draft in 1965 put an end to it. These so-called bonus babies included the likes of Sandy Koufax, Al Kaline, Harmon Killebrew, and Catfish Hunter, and Joey Jay, who spent 7 seasons with the Braves before being traded to the Reds in 1960. He finished his Major League career in 1966 back with the Braves, but this time the franchise was located in Atlanta. Jay rang up a record of 99 wins and 91 losses with an ERA of 3.77, was one strikeout away from 1,000 for his career. The right-hander was a switch hitter and helped his own cause by hitting 2 home runs during his career, both coming in 1962 with Cincinnati. Besides being a bonus baby, Joey Jay is also best remembered as the first Little League player to make it all the way to the major leagues. For It Happened in Baseball, I'm Mick Kern.
SiriusXM has soccer covered end to end. SiriusXM FC. Hear live play-by-play and talk shows hosted by legends of the game. It's SiriusXM FC on Channel 157.
If it's NCAA March Madness, it's on Westwood One.
We welcome you to our NCAA broadcast headquarters in Los Angeles for regional final doubleheader coverage of the 2024 Men's Basketball Championship. Today's broadcast of the NCAA tournament on the Westwood One NCAA Radio Network is sponsored by Cintas, by Kohl's, by Grainger, by CDW, by Progressive Insurance, and by NCAA.com. Hey, folks, how are you? Along with college basketball analyst Doug Gottlieb, I'm Jason Horowitz, and we once again welcome you to our exclusive coverage of the 2024 NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament. Within the next 5.5 hours, we will know half of the Final Four, and then we'll get it all going again tomorrow as we check the schedule of tournament games coming up on Westwood One, sponsored by Duluth Trading Company. Duluth Trading Company stacks your starting lineup with higher performing gear all year round, plus keeps all your zones covered and comfy. Online or in store, get into Duluth today. We are just about 8 minutes away from tipping things off in Boston. Reigning national champion UConn against Illinois, trying to get to the Final Four for the first time in 19 years. Then later on tonight, it's a 4-6 matchup. Alabama and Clemson at 8:49 Eastern from Los Angeles. One of those teams is going to go to the Final Four for the first time ever. We will, of course, get you out there. And then, of course, 2 more games tomorrow from Detroit and Dallas. But, Doug, we'll start with the opener here. 2 of the best teams in the country. They played great offense all year. What are you expecting tonight between UConn and Illinois?
Okay, so if you haven't, in this case, heard Illinois play earlier this year, you should know that they play a unique style. It's essentially 5 guys outside the 3-point line. They have transfers across the board. Marcus Domask is essentially their point guard. He can back you all the way down from midcourt and is fantastic in the mid-range as a passer and a scorer. Keep an eye on Quincy Gurrier, who's a 2-time transfer. He's 6'8", but really more of a perimeter player, but he's a slasher and he'll cut when you're not looking. And then Coleman Hawkins, who's a uniquely talented player, can play inside and out. And then, of course, you have Terrence Shannon Jr., but it's a 5-out style that starts with, if you remember the old Knicks days of Mark Jackson, when we played in the NBA, backing guys down, they call it a booty ball offense, and then they wait. If you don't help, Damask can score. If you do help, he finds the open player, and they just kind of play very, very free. It's unique, and it'll be interesting to see how UConn guards it.
And it should be a great basketball game. UConn has not been tested in this tournament, or for that matter, in last tournament. We get it going on the other side from the Westwood One NCAA Radio Network. This is the Men's Basketball Tournament.
They are among the greatest to ever play their sports.
Caitlin Clark is the all-time scoring leader.
They are legends and icons.
Larry Bird hit the shot with no second thought. I don't know how he did it.
And you can hear them right now on the all-new Sirius XM app.
We are here with Iowa superstar Caitlin Clark.
I'm so focused on winning. It's never anything I ever take for granted.
Here comes Larry Bird, the Hall of Famer, and he just won Legend of the Year.
Legend of the Year, isn't that something?
For access to the game's greats, rely on the leader in sports audio. Sirius XM and the Sirius XM app.
Throughout March, Coach K breaks down the NCAA tournament on Sirius XM.
To me, the hardest game a coach has to win is the Elite Eight.
Hear men's college basketball's winningest coach share his unique perspective.
The most pressure that a coach has, he not only sees the promised land, he knows the bridge that you have to go over.
It's Basketball and Beyond with Coach K. Tuesdays and Wednesdays at 5 Eastern on College Sports Radio Channel 84 in the car and the all-new Sirius XM app.
Your home for analysis and reaction of ACC teams in the NCAA Women's Basketball Tournament is ACC Today.
Knocks it down and pumps her fist.
Join us weekdays from 8 to 11 a.m. Eastern on SiriusXM ACC Radio. We'll be breaking down the action with ACC basketball experts like Dallin Cuff.
That team is going to be a tough out.
John Henson.
Everybody's got a chance.
Plus, we'll be talking to players and coaches as they advance through March. Weekdays from 8 to 11 a.m. Eastern on ACC Radio, Channel 371.
That is huge.
The Women's NCAA Tournament is on Sirius XM.
It is going to be fun. It is going to be interesting.
For the best guests.
Caitlin Clark.
I feel like we're playing really good basketball right now.
And coverage of March Madness. Tune in to Sirius XM Big Ten Radio from the biggest stars.
Holmes left-handed layup. She's got another 30-piece.
To the top teams. We've got you covered through the national championship in Cleveland. It's all on Sirius XM Big Ten Radio, Channel 372, and the all-new Sirius XM app.
Welcome back to Westwood One's exclusive coverage of the men's basketball tournament from our Verizon studios. Get the network you can rely on for your phone and your home internet and save. Find the plan that's right for you at Verizon.com. It all gets going now in Boston, UConn, and Illinois. Here's Scott Graham and Jordan Cornett.
Well, Jason, this building right now is filled to the rafters and poised to explode as these teams are about to be introduced out onto the floor. What an interesting ball game we have got here in terms of this game, this matchup. And again, is this the one team that has had the ability so far to at least test UConn?
This is the lone team, I feel like, in this field where I said if they get a crack at UConn, they are so uniquely suited with their personnel and how they score the basketball to apply game pressure and make this interesting. And Scott, here we are.
And so UConn head coach Danny Hurley's teams have been blowing teams out the entire tournament, but he says he expects tonight's game against Illinois to be a close one.
You know, the expectation in the game versus Illinois, Illinois is one of the best teams in the country. You know, one of the best teams in the country. We expect a 40-minute war going into every game that we go into. You know, I know you'll see, you know, the end of that clip when I came into the locker room and said, we just keep blowing these teams out. Well, they missed the first part of that, which was, man, I don't know how we're blowing these teams out in this setting. You guys are special.
All right, so against that backdrop here in a darkened arena, it's time for Jordan Cornett's Keys to the Game, sponsored by the members of the National Association of Realtors. There's a lot to buying a home. Negotiations, inspections, timelines. Realtors have the expertise to guide you through the process. Realtors are members of the National Association of Realtors.
Let's talk with that group Hurley's going to face in the Illini, the higher seed. For Illinois, we know this UConn offense is explosive, dangerous, one of the best in the country. They must communicate defensively. A lot of actions, a lot of movement. They'll work it in the clock. Scott, as you mentioned at the beginning of our broadcast, you have to be connected defensively. Also, Illinois at their best, and why they're the number one offense, is when they play with pace. They have to play fast, off misses, off makes, get in passing lanes, try to chase easy ones to get their offense kickstarted. That's when it's flying truly high. For UConn, this is booty ball with Illinois. So the number one key for them is a defensive key as well. Win your one-on-one scenarios defensively. Take pride in guarding in isolation and force tough ones. Late contest, make guys meet chests, whatever you have to do. And then finally, for this UConn team to survive and advance back to the Final Four and continue to defend their title, they must be aggressive on a backcourt. 21 offensive rebounds was massive in that win over San Diego State. Illinois is going to bring the pain. Who wins the backboard could ultimately tell the story of this one.
All right, so as they continue to introduce the starting lineups, let's check those lineups. Sponsored by Cintas. Workdays are better when you partner with Cintas. Keep your team protected, prepared, and looking great. Visit Cintas.com and get ready for the workday. Illinois 29-8. They start Marcus DeMass, graduate student out of Waupun, Wisconsin, averages almost 16 points per game. Quincy Guerrier, grad student out of Montreal, averaging 9.5 points and 6 rebounds. Ty Rogers, a sophomore, 6'6", 210 out of Saginaw, Michigan. He averages 6.5 points and 5.5 boards. And Coleman Hawkins, playing in his 126th game at Illinois, senior, 6'10", 230 out of Sacramento, California. Of course, we left the best for last. Terrence Shannon, Jr., fifth-year player out of Chicago, averaging 23.5 points per game. And a guy who is scoring 31-plus points per game in this postseason in 2024. The head coach is Brad Underwood, seventh year, 143 wins at Illinois, 252 in his coaching career. The UConn Huskies, the defending national champs, are 34-3. They will start Tristan Newton, grad student, 6'5", 195 out of El Paso, a do-it-all player, better than 15 points, almost 7 rebounds and 6 assists per game. Stephon Castle, the freshman of the year in the Big East, 6'6", 215 out of Covington, Georgia. He's joined by Alex Caravan. He was one of the starters last year, as well as Newton, on that championship team. Redshirt sophomore out of Southboro, Massachusetts, averages 13 points and 5 boards. Cam Spencer, grad transfer, averaging 14.5 points per game. He's 6'4", 205. And the big man, Donovan Klingon, 7'2", 280 out of Bristol, Connecticut. Head coach is Dan Hurley, the Big East Coach of the Year, who's won 289 games now in his coaching career. Time for the opening tip-off, sponsored by Progressive. See why over 28 million drivers trust Progressive to stay protected on the road. See for yourself at progressive.com. Connecticut in the home white with the red and blue trim. Illinois in the traveling orange with the blue and white trim. Terry Oglesby, the referee for tonight, joined by Doug Shals and Byron Jarrett. Oglesby has the ball at center court, tosses it up, and UConn controls the tap, going from our left over to our right. Be ready to see a lot of movement from this UConn team. They drop it down low on the block and down inside. Klingon can't finish close. Ball gets trapped between the rim and the backboard. And on the alternate possession, just 16 seconds in, Illinois is getting it back. But more importantly, we saw this the other night. Donovan Klingon struggled to finish at the rim.
And that's it, Scott. Point blank range, a concerted effort on the first possession to acclimate their big right at the post, right at the finish at the rim. Couldn't complete. Does that continue? Something to monitor.
DeMass just across half court. Picked up there by Tristan Newton. Waiting for a cutter. Gets it off to Rogers. Rogers back to DeMass right side. Dribbles top of the circle. Now up into the hands of Shannon. The left-hander is so dangerous. Sidestep, drive, into the lane, in traffic, shot off the backboard, no good. Great job defensively by Stephon Castle to get the rebound, but he gets it ripped away, and now the ball taken away from Shannon, who was on the ground. And they have to question right now where the shot clock is. Did possession change? It's down to 0.9, so the officials blew the whistle, but they are going to say that it is indeed Connecticut basketball.
And I think it might be a shot clock violation was ultimately the call there, because the ball didn't hit the rim. There wasn't possession. I think the clock ran out.
It still said 0.9, though.
Yeah, I think that was an ultimate determination for Terry Oglesby. That was a shot clock violation.
All right, so weird first possession on both sides of the ball. Here comes Castle into the forecourt for UConn. Just inside the March Madness logo. Picks up the dribble, goes for Caravan. Back to Castle in the middle. Inside, Klingon's open, and he jams it home. He got inside Coleman Hawkins, 2-0 UConn.
And they really like the advantage size-wise with Klingon down low. Play up top, pass over the defense. Klingon leaves nothing a chance with a dunk finish.
Here's Shannon, kicking to the near side corner. Coleman Hawkins back to the top. Now Hawkins gets a return pass just left top of the circle. With a left-hand dribble, step to the side and drive the shot. No good. Long rebound down, and it's covered by Castle. UConn into the forecourt. Castle's shot, no good. Klingon the offensive rebound. The putback and the foul. The big man asserting himself early. He's got a chance at a three-point play.
Klingon running the floor is rewarded. Big fella changes ends as good as any 7'2" guy you'll see in the game.
Hit the like button.
Castle in transition with pace, gets it up off the glass. And because of Klingon's effort, he's able to get in pristine offensive rebounding position, put back in some contact.
Klingon's free throw is good, so he's got all 5 points for the Huskies, a 5-0 UConn lead, just over 90 seconds in here in Boston. Winner goes to the Final Four next week in Arizona. DeMask takes a left-handed dribble to the left side. Foul line extended, backing his way in, working on Newton. This is booty ball. I get it back out on top. DeMask takes the return pass. trying to shovel it down low. He's in the lane in trouble. Shot clock down to 8. Gets it off on the near side for Rogers, who loses the ball. Here comes UConn in transition again. And they're running the floor. Far side, Castle, clinging now on the high post. Dribble to the near side, hands it off for Newton, driving into the lane. His left-handed shot is no good. Fight for the rebound. Klingon got a hand on it, but it's covered by Guerrier for Illinois.
Klingon continues to be all over the offensive glass, so Illinois needs to tighten up there.
Damask has his shot blocked by Caravan. Took it all the way down to the baseline, tried to make space, but Caravan with a long arm flicks it over the end line. Illinois will keep it.
As good as UConn's been on the glass early on, Scott, they've been that good defensively as well, contesting everything, keeping bodies in front, active hands.
Illinois still looking for their first point. Rogers in the lane, little floater, no good. Rebound down off a couple of hands, and it's picked up off the ground by Stephon Castle for UConn. 5-0 lead for the Huskies with the basketball. On the near side, it's Cam Spencer. Spencer back up on top to Castle, the freshman driving to the foul line, into the lane. Powers his way up with the left-hand shot, no good. Rebound taken down, the putback right there, once again for Klingon. He's got 7 points. It's Klingon 7, Illinois nothing.
You got to get danger in the ballgame. You need a more physical body. Hawkins being dominated down low.
On a drive inside. Rogers got the ball to the rim, and then he was tripped when he got there. That's going to be a foul call. It's going to be against UConn. It's going to be on Donovan Klingon, his first. And it's going to mean free throws coming for sophomore Ty Rogers for Illinois.
I mean, Klingon, Scott, shot out of a cannon. Just loitering around that low block, waiting for good things to happen. It's been a dunk finish and a couple offensive rebound putbacks. He is totally overwhelming the Illinois front line, or lack thereof, because Coleman Hawkins is playing that 5 spot.
Rogers, just a 60% free throw shooter. First one is on the way, and it's no good. Later on, we'll select the coaching move of the day, sponsored by O'Reilly Auto Parts. Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need fast from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts. They were only 15 for 29 from the line here the other night. They are in the middle of a free throw shooting slump. Rogers' second is no good. Illinois still scoreless, just over 3 minutes in.
Inexplicable. One of the best free throw shooting teams in the Big Ten this season just hasn't traveled in the postseason, that free throw shooter.
Here's Klingon, shovels back behind, and a three-pointer from the left side, no good for Newton. Rebound taken down by Damask, and a quick outlet for Rogers. Here comes Illinois. Rogers driving, dishing, and Danger, who had checked in right before that last free throw, steps on the end line as he takes the pass. This is, could not go much worse for Illinois in the opening 3.5 minutes.
And they're lucky it's only 7-0 on the UConn side with this lead, but inexplicable on the outlet pass. Rogers had a clear path on the left side to continue with pace to maybe get to the rim, but he cut across right side where two defenders from UConn were waiting for him.
Klingon comes out of the game. Samson Johnson checks in. He's got the ball now right at the top of the circle. With a left-hand dribble, hands it off for Newton. Newton driving and dishing. An alley-oop guided through the rim by Samson Johnson. It's 9-0 UConn. They got a media timeout coming, but right now, Rufus caving in on this Illinois team. Damask picked up by Newton at half court. Driving into the paint. Shot blocked away, but he's fouled by Tristan Newton. And he's going to get an opportunity to shoot a couple of free throws when we come back. Right now, all the defending champs here in Boston. 4 minutes in. It's 16 minutes to go in the first half of play. It's UConn 9, Illinois nothing. For the Westwood One NCAA Radio Network, this is the Men's Basketball Tournament.
I'm Erin, and this is my life with California Closets. I purchased a historic home that's over 150 years old. One of the biggest things old houses don't have is closet storage and organization. And in a modern life, you really need to store a lot of things. Working with California Closets was the only way to get exactly what I needed. It really makes my life better. I finally have my dream home, and I couldn't be more thrilled about it.
Visit a showroom or schedule your free design consultation today at californiaclosets.com. If you only have a 401k, you're not getting the most for retirement.
Wait, what?
Add a Robinhood IRA on top, then they'll boost it by 3%.
You can do that?
And if you transfer in any retirement account, you get 3% on top of that.
Is there a limit to the match?
No limit. Robinhood Gold gets you the biggest contribution match of any IRA on the market. Sign up for Robinhood Gold at Robinhood.com/boost by April 30th. Subscription fees apply.
Investing involves risk. 3% match requires gold for 1 year from first match. Must keep IRA for 5 years. Match on transfers subject to additional terms and conditions. Robinhood Financial LLC. Member SIPC.
Old Man Winter here. One more snowstorm
and... Not a chance, Mr. Winter. It's spring.
It's also time for the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event, where you can get great deals on all our award-winning Hyundai models, all backed by America's best warranty. Hurry in. These deals won't last at the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Now get 0% APR or up to $1,500 bonus cash on the Hyundai Tucson. Now, during the Hyundai Getaway Sales Event. Offers end soon. Call 562-314-4603 for details.
I'm Amy, and this is my life with California Closets. This is an amazing time in my life. We got married, new home, baby on the way. I needed my own sanctuary space. California Closets worked with us to give us everything we wanted. When I enter my closet, it's calm, it's organized, it's its own oasis. This closet is my dream closet.
Visit a showroom or schedule your free design consultation today at californiaclosets.com.
You can listen to the live stream of every remaining game of both the NCAA men's and women's tournaments on WestwoodOneSports.com, sponsored by Wendy's. Get a Dave's single for just $1 and a Dave's double for just $2 with the offers in the Wendy's app. Wendy's, the official hamburger of March Madness. Limited time offer at participating U.S. Wendy's. Redeem in Wendy's app. Account registration required. See offer in Wendy's app for details. 9-0 UConn. You're Brad Underwood right now. You go into that Illinois huddle. What are you saying?
Slow down offensively, play within your game. But beyond that, we have to be tougher on the inside defensive rebounding. Those offensive rebounds have been, there's only been two of them, but they've been devastating from Klingon, and Klingon almost got a third. But they've scored points off both offensive rebounds. 5 points there, they're taking five more shots. A toughness and settling in for Illinois offensively is key.
Right now, Illinois looking at their largest deficit of the tournament so far as Marcus DeMas goes to the line. First free throw is around and no good. They have missed three in a row and are now in this building 15 out of 32 from the free throw line. DeMas is an 88% shooter. Takes a bounce, eyes it up, fires and hits. There's your first point of the ball game. It's 9-1. UConn on top. Just 4 minutes in here in Boston. Tristan Newton slides it to the near side into the hands of Cam Spencer. Spencer, right side foul line extended. Waiting for a cutter, nothing there. Back to Newton up on top. Around a screen. He'll stop the top of the circle, get it to Caravan. One touch near side for Spencer. Spencer on the run into the lane. Spinning at the elbow, nothing there. Five on the shot clock now. Newton will step back a three. That shot no good. And DeMas comes down with a rebound for Illinois. Illini try to get something going here offensively as DeMas backs his way in, spins on Spencer, now dishes in a two-fisted jam for Quincy Guerrier, who snuck in on the left baseline.
Booty ball on full display on the right side in isolation. DeMas going to back down on Spencer. They try to send a second defender. Block-to-block pass for Guerrier with the flush.
9-3 our score, 5 minutes in. UConn in the forecourt now. Ball in the hands of Castle. Finds a cutting Spencer. Spencer into the lane and an easy look. He was wide open for a soft little floater from 5 feet away. It's 11-3 UConn.
Looked like Spencer was going to float it from the free throw line, but kind of allowed himself with a double bump to get closer to the rim with essentially a finger roll, but shot it as a floater.
Near side of the floor, Coleman Hawkins holds. Bounce it again for DeMas. The offense going through him. He drives. Shot with the left hand is good. Did a good job of getting Newton inside. 11-5 UConn.
Rip through, explosive first step, allows him to beat the defender. Stood up Newton.
Spencer takes it right into the lane, kicks out far side. Castle a three. Shot is no good. Rebound for Guerrier for Illinois. They're down by six as they come into the forecourt.
Shannon still looking to get going in this one.
That's only his second touch as he gets the basketball, then bounces it back into the hands of Coleman Hawkins at middle of the floor. Hawkins, crossover dribble, take into the lane. Drop step, nothing there. Spinning, nothing there. Shot up, no good. And the rebound ripped down by Sampson Johnson for UConn.
Johnson's sublime job of not biting on any of the head fakes or the exaggerated pivot.
Newton, an aggressive drive to the left baseline, now throws back to Castle up at the top. Castle with the dribble, the freshman at the head of the circle. As Johnson is a screen, but instead sends it back, they'll reset it with Tristan Newton. Shot clock down to 8. Newton with the dribble in the left hand, on the left side. Now driving into the paint, running shot up, no good, but a whistle and a foul call. And Tristan Newton is going to the free throw line with a foul call coming on Luke Goody for Illinois.
Newton needed all he could get from the ball screen from Johnson to open him up to give him some sort of gap to pursue. Never really had an angle. Overzealous defense from Shannon, who's clearly frustrated because he's not been able to get his offensive game going to this point.
Scott Graham, Jordan Cornette here at our Granger courtside seats in Boston. Gain a winning edge for your business with Granger. You'll find supplies and solutions for every industry when you call, click Granger.com, or stop by one of the over 250 branches nationwide. Newton's first foul shot is good. That makes it 12-5, UConn on top. 13-26 to go here in the first half. A couple of substitutions, including Hassan Diarra coming into the ball game for UConn, as Stephon Castle takes a seat. Newton's second free throw is up, and that one is good. 13-5 Huskies. Illinois once again for Damask, who takes it straight into the forecourt and then backs it all the way out near half court. Diarra is the guy trying to guard Shannon now. We'll see how that goes. Shannon gets the ball, comes around a screen, flares back behind to Guerrier. Guerrier driving in the paint. Shot no good. Goody down with a rebound though for Illinois. Outside for a three. It's good for Marcus Damask. 13-8 the score.
Best time to get a three off, and a good one is off an offensive rebound. Some toughness from Luke Goody. An outlet outside top of the key. Damask wide open from distance.
Carabad behind the screen. Fires a three. That's no good. Goody down with a rebound for the Illini. Here comes Shannon. Like a freight train down the lane. And his shot is good. Blew past everyone and got his team back within three.
And more importantly for the Illini, Scott, they're playing with a pace now that we haven't seen in the first 8 minutes.
And Newton's going to slow him down, dribbling the ball away right in front of us. Finds his cutter in Spencer. Now Johnson, one touch far side, Diarra. Back to Newton. He'll start the offense. Driving. Euro step shot. No good. Rebound down to Coleman Hawkins. Here come the Illini once again. Hawkins lead back behind for Guerrier. He wants a three. That shot is no good. And the rebound off a couple of hands. Finally corralled by Carabin for UConn.
May have been a force from Guerrier. Excited by the moment and the momentum of his Illini group. A regrettable delivery.
Diarra nearly lost the handle and dribbles it back out to the midcourt area. 11:45 to go till halftime. We got a three-point game. Diarra driving shot up, and it is good. Kissed it off the glass and the rim. 15-10, UConn on top.
Diarra patient. They thought he was going to reverse it, fake the reverse, drove left side, and finished with his dominant hand.
Damask stops for a three and nails it. From 24 feet away, he just stopped and popped and got his team back within two. It's 15-13.
You're seeing it right now. Illinois can play with the offensive firepower of UConn's. They can match it.
Shot clock at three. Johnson down low off of Illinois. UConn will have it. Under 11 minutes to go. Illinois has scored on six of the last eight trips.
Did you hit the like button? Come on, hit the like button. And subscribe too. Join the family.
From the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, the Ego Power Plus Blower, reaching an incredible 765 CFM. And it runs up to 90 minutes on a single charge, exclusively at Lowe's, Ace, and Ego authorized dealers.
Pan pizza is Domino's best kept secret. It's handmade with fresh, never frozen dough, has two layers of cheese, toppings to the edge, and a crust that's golden and crispy. Well, consider the secret out. Order your favorite pan pizza or try it today for the first time at Domino's.
Awkward question. Is there going to be anything
left over?
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
My kids don't know what they want. You know who knows what she wants? Me!
With Empower, we get all of our financial questions answered, so you don't have to worry.
Empower, what's next?
One kale celery swirl?
Yeah.
Cash or charge?
Charge.
Sorry, game time.
This is a hot flash. This is a hot flash. But this is a not flash. For moderate to severe vasomotor symptoms due to menopause, Veozah is the first and only prescription treatment that directly blocks the source of hot flashes and night sweats. With 100% hormone-free Veozah, you can have fewer hot flashes and more not flashes. Veozah reduces the number and severity of hot flashes, day and night. For some women, it can start working in as early as 1 week. Don't use Veozah if you have cirrhosis, severe kidney problems, kidney failure, or take CYP1A2 inhibitors. Increased liver blood test values may occur. Your doctor will check them before and during treatment. Most common side effects include stomach pain, diarrhea, difficulty sleeping, and back pain.
I get a good feeling.
Ask your doctor about hormone-free Veozah and enjoy more not flashes.
A reminder, Masters Live, watch it now for exclusive coverage of Amen Corner, 15 and 16 in feature groups. Watch live on the CBS Sports app. Moments ago, Andy Katz caught up with the coach of number one seed UConn, Dan Hurley.
Well, Danny, you're about to put Donovan Klingon back in. What made him so effective in those first 4 minutes?
Just obviously matchup, opportunity to go high-low. You know, they have an advantage down here. You know, playing him in space with five out, but we got a big advantage down there with him.
Thanks, Danny.
And they've got 1.4 to get this shot away. Klingon catches and fires. Shannon had the ball, finally grabbed by Goody. Here come the Illini. Shannon, the third-ranked scorer in college basketball, hits the deck on the miss. It's picked up by Spencer the other way. Now Castle, slashing inside. On the floor, they're getting tangled up and crackling it out of bounds. It goes. It will be Illinois' ball.
That was a great play in transition by Danger to go straight up in the air and to avoid the foul. You know, what is going on?
That's great hustle, and it does go off Klingon. It is amazing to me, having watched between 35 and 40 college games in the last 2 weeks, how much, no, but seriously, how much more physical the college game is than the NBA.
Tiara pokes it away, shot clock. Manageable at 15 seconds. Damask. DR defends the bump. Out of bounds. It's Connecticut's ball.
I mean, he just hit Damask on his elbow shooting the ball. Shannon got fouled on that last drive. I mean, it's amazing the amount of contact they allow in college basketball.
UConn has lost one game since January 1st. 23-1. Spencer, three. Rebound pulled inside by Justin Harmon off the bench. Grant Sr., who has played elsewhere, takes it in right here. It's a rebound. It's Cam Spencer. And the other way for the Huskies. Klingon a screen. Good feed. Tiara will complete it.
That's Tiara's second basket tonight.
He really provides a spark coming off the bench. And if Harmon is going to drive the ball to the basket, if Klingon is there, he's got to pull up and shoot the mid-range jumper. He's not shooting it over Klingon.
Here comes Illinois. They've won seven consecutive games. Damask defended by Diarra. Loose. Danger tries to save the ball, and it's out of bounds. It's UConn's ball. Watch the men's Elite Eight on your computer, phone, tablet, or streaming device with NCAA March Madness Live. Download now to stay up to date on all the action.
I'm surprised that Danger's come out of the game, and they're going to go back to Hawkins on Klingon. UConn's going to go right at that, I would think.
It's Castle, Klingon, Hawkins defends.
I mean, if he's going to catch the ball that close to the basket, again, he's got 50 pounds on Hawkins. There's not a thing that Hawkins can do.
Hawkins has absolutely no chance against him.
He'll take it in, Klingon defends. Swipes the ball. Great rebound by Rogers.
And Rogers, a great offensive rebound.
He leads him. Here comes Shannon. Rejected Klingon. Picked up Hawkins. Three. No. Rebound inside. Fuck four. Foul. UConn.
Klingon just, I mean, he roots his face inside, and then Hawkins, there's just nothing he can do. Now, I think that Illinois hasn't gotten the message yet. It's going to be really hard to go right at Klingon. Maybe take a mid-range jump shot.
Jalen Stewart is checked in for the Huskies. Here comes Guerrier. He'll come in for Justin Harmon. Illinois, seven consecutive missed shots. Goodyear inbound, quickly cutting inside. Wow! Klingon got the ball and got the player. He's got a couple blocks, and Shannon felt the wrath of that defense.
You just can't be looking for the foul in that situation. You're not going to get it.
Certainly not in college basketball. They don't call fouls going to the basket.
29 wins for the Illini, most in 19 years. Here they go up high. Shannon caught, comes down, goes up, and feeds, and Rogers on the doorstep couldn't get it.
Passes
up the rebound.
He was looking for Klingon, even though Klingon wasn't there.
Diarra, three. It's a goodie rebound for the Illini. He's got four off the bench. Hawkins the other way. Rogers driving into Klingon.
Yeah, it looks like their game plan, Dan, is to challenge Klingon every time down the floor. That is far from working well for them at this point.
He's a top 10 shot blocker in the college basketball world.
He sure is, Kevin, and that's with playing only 22 minutes a game.
Stan, I'm not sure that Illinois has scored with Klingon in the game.
It's Klingon. Hawkins is on him. Undersized, 7-2 against 6-10. Shot clock at one. Newton fires, good if it goes. It's loose and out of bounds and off of UConn. Illinois ball, 7:20 in the first half.
Don't let me go.
Introducing the all-new 2024 Lincoln Nautilus Hybrid.
There's nothing better than a Subway Series footlong, except when you add an all-new footlong sidekick. Like the Philly with a new $2 footlong churro.
Sometimes the sidekick is the main event.
You would say that. Every epic footlong deserves the perfect sidekick.
TNT.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Nissan, official partner of March Madness. Cologuard. Progressive. Bundle home and auto and save. And by Subway. Try a delicious new sidekick at Subway today.
Welcome back to Boston. Taking a look at the Nissan first half stats. The two best offenses in college basketball shooting a combined 31%.
Kevin, it's been a game that's been dominated by defense. And guys, you know, we've talked a lot about over this last nine games, Connecticut stretch in the NCAA tournament, where they've been dominant. Well, they haven't been dominant today. And I guess if you're going to win another championship, every once in a while you have to win ugly. And they're right now, they're winning ugly.
And they are. And this is a winnable game right now for Illinois. But they've got to change their approach. This idea that we're just going to go at Donovan Clingan and try to score over the top of him is not working. They can penetrate, come to a stop. Shotgun, look at the numbers. They're 4-for-24 when Clingan's in the game. They've got to go, shot fake, get him off his feet, or draw the help and make the next play. Right now, they need to make better decisions.
Let's send it over to Andy Katz.
Well, it's funny you say that, Stan, because Brad Underwood told me we got to shoot threes. We've had threes that we did not take, whether that's Shannon, Guerrier, Domask, Dawkins. We got to take threes. And he did say, by the way, we're kind of where this game thought it would be. 23 all, 1 point. Okay, we're down five. We're okay. But yes, we need to shoot more threes, Stan and Dan.
Clinging inside. Hawkins is there. 11 for Clinging.
He's letting him get too deep. He's letting him come all the way down to the restricted area before he meets him. He's got to meet him just below the free throw line, not let him get as deep.
It's Shannon inside on the fly. Tip in. Rogers could not get it. And they got Cam Spencer weaving his way the other way.
I think it's early, but I think we're already in a danger zone for Illinois here.
Milton plunging into the paint. Clingan got the ball. He and Marcus Dimash were going at it. It's out of bounds. The officials look at each other. We're going to say it's UConn's ball.
I mean, Illinois is playing hard on the defense.
That is not UConn ball. That ball was off Clingan. That is a bad call.
Well, the guys underneath the basket didn't see it.
Either did the guy outside.
Wow, somebody needed to make a call, and they just guessed wrong.
Clinging a second to shoot. Knocked away. And a drive inside. Caravan kept that alive. Illinois comes out unscathed.
What a defensive play by Shannon to disrupt that shot. He didn't block the shot, but Spencer saw him flying by and missed the layup.
It's Marcus Dimash. Working his way in. Over Caravan. Clinging the rebound.
I like the matchup change to have Caravan on Damask. Better size to take away the back end game. I think it was accidental.
We were tied at 23. UConn has gone on a 9-0 run. Shannon remains quiet.
Boy, there's no movement for Illinois. They're just standing around watching one guy dribble.
Right now, Dimash. He lost it inside.
Well, that's how Illinois plays. They go to a lot of isolation.
Foul called on the perimeter. Marcus Dimash will pick up number two for Illinois.
Well, this is what UConn can do. They can push it.
Dimash slow getting back there. Caravan outran him.
Well, Dimash misses that shot. It's sort of a fall away. He's off balance. And you got to give a lot of credit to Caravan for just getting out and going.
Goody has come in for Illinois. Nudging his way inside. Clinging. Foul.
Well, that's the matchup Danny Hurley told Andy early in the game he liked. And Klingon is just, I mean, he's just a bull in there.
Rose Goody picks up his second personal foul for Illinois.
I'm not sure what he's complaining about on that foul. That's obvious. They've run that a lot. Klingon pins down for Castle. Castle catches the ball and goes high-low into Klingon.
Cheer on your favorite NCAA team with officially licensed fan gear. For the best selection of team apparel and accessories, head to ncaa.com/shop. Here is the two-time Connecticut High School Player of the Year, Donovan Klingon, who has just given the defending champions their biggest lead tonight in the Elite Eight. Shannon will drive. They'll feed. Gary rejected. Klingon with his fourth block shot. Spencer. Castle. Klingon.
There are trucks, and then there's the GMC Sierra, available with the connected driving experience. And the world's first six-function multi-pro tailgate. GMC Sierra. It's the truck. Or get $6,000 purchase allowance when you trade in an eligible vehicle. That's 10% below MSRP on select GMC Sierra models. We are professional grade GMC.
Remember when I said we need to screen for colon cancer?
Was that after I texted the age to screen was now 45? Because I said Cologuard.
Hey there.
Where did he come from?
Yep, with me, you can screen at home. Just talk to your provider.
We'll screen with Cologuard. And do it my way.
Cologuard is a one-of-a-kind way to screen for colon cancer that's effective and non-invasive. It's for people 45 plus at average risk, not high risk. False positive and negative results may occur.
Ask your provider for me, Cologuard.
Okay, when you turn around, you're going to see someone.
You have a turkey and cheese.
Let's imagine that LL Cool J has a bubble around him. Do we want to be
inside?
Hey,
I'm Keith.
There are some situations that young homeowners turning into their parents just can't handle.
Yep, there he is. There's my nephew. Now, I got a video of him playing piano.
That's not how you take a selfie.
Progressive can't save you from becoming your parents, but we can save you money when you bundle home and auto with us.
3, 2, 1.
We don't need a countdown. Just take the picture.
My Lowe's Rewards credit card saves us 5% on the things we need.
5% off, 5% off, 5% off.
And as loyalty members, we get points toward Milo's money for the things we want.
Oh, we want this.
The all-new Milo's Rewards loyalty program is here. Download the app to join, earn, and save today.
There's nothing better than a Subway Series footlong, except when you add on an all-new footlong sidekick. We're talking a $2 footlong churro, $3 footlong pretzel, and a $5 footlong cookie. Every epic footlong deserves a perfect sidekick. Order one with your favorite Subway Series sub today.
Nice. AT&T just sent me a heads up on the best plan for me. I'm all about good advice.
Melo, you give horrible advice.
Draft night 2003, here we go.
Are you sure about this, Melo?
Where does the suit end and perk begin?
Trust me, these suits are timeless classics.
Bossy boys.
What?
AT&T provides proactive recommendations so you get what's right for you.
And now a look from our AT&T Connected Cam. And Klingon is the focus.
Well, Klingon has been the guy. He's got 14 points. He's got 9 rebounds. He's got 4 block shots. And he's got 2 steals.
Larry David is here enjoying the game in Boston. Many, many fans from Stores, Connecticut. In fact, they're calling this Stores North.
But on that last block, Kevin, if Shannon made a good play, if Guerrier stays in the corner, he's got a wide open three, and he's a 38% three-point shooter.
Guerrier on top, launches a three. Rebound, Shannon. Guerrier, Goody, he'll launch a three. Rebound inside off the fingertips of the flying Shannon.
Illinois ball.
To Illinois is now 4 of 30 with Klingon on the floor.
This is what you're talking about, Stan. Guerrier is right there. He's in the corner. Klingon is inside. If Guerrier just stays where he was, Shannon makes an excellent pass. Guerrier has a wide open three. Now, Brett Underwood said they needed to shoot more threes. What he really meant is they needed to make threes.
Absolutely.
And they've had a couple of open ones and they've missed them.
But this last possession has been more intelligent. They are making plays like that. Now they got to make shots.
Trey Gibbs Wanhorn just came off the bench and in for the Illini. Caravan inside. Connecticut is on a 14-0 run, going back to the late stages of the first half. And Illinois has been scoreless over the last 5 minutes. Hawkins tees up a three. Newton's got the rebound. Caravan a three. No. Rebound inside. Spencer.
You've earned this, so hold it up high. This isn't a hobby, it's a lifestyle. You find diamonds in the rust to put your own stamp on stock parts, turning metal into murals and detailing every detail. Because it's the things you make that show what you're made of. You are a fighter, and this is your reward. Modelo, the mark of a fighter.
Domino's perfect combo includes two pizzas, two sides, and a 2-liter bottle of Coke. So we were asking real people how much they think all of this costs.
$35,
$45,
$50.
$19.99.
I'm about to order that when I get home.
It's Domino's perfect combo, and it's all just $19.99.
It's what we dance right here. Hey, yo!
New Balance, we got now.
So what is the next big thing? Well, Galaxy believes the next big thing is you.
Me?
Yes, look at you. You're open to experiment. You open your heart.
I have a play this weekend.
And with the power of Galaxy AI, you'll open even more possibilities and open your imagination. We're putting all that power in your hands. The next big thing is you.
It's true that you've got to forget something else to remember that Uber Eats has groceries.
No, that's absurd. Hey, remember when you used to be a, what was it, a pepper lady?
Wasn't it Cinnamon Sisters?
Basil Babes.
Saffron Squad?
Nutmeg Maidens?
Wayfair helps all of us create a home we love.
The Wayfair vibe at our place is Western.
But we all got our own thing.
Drama.
Glamour.
Gardening.
In the neighborhood, there's a place for all of us.
Wayfair, every style, every home.
And now, thrilling drives presented by Nissan. We were tied at 23 with 1:49 to go in the first half. Connecticut has gone on a 16-0 run since that 23 all ball game.
And they've scored inside, they've scored in transition, they've gotten offensive rebounds.
If you hit the like
more
button,
like the Connecticut team we've
hit the
seen,
like button.
Although they're still only 1-for-13 from outside the arc.
It's Marcus Damas. Newton is on him. Screened by Hawkins. Back to Hawkins. Watching the three. Another miss. Under 23% shooting for Illinois in this gigantic game.
Well, but the last three possessions, they've had a more intelligent attack to go at Kling and throw the ball back to open people. But Dan hit on it. They don't need to just shoot threes. They've got to make some.
Yeah, but the first step was getting good ones, and they've gotten there.
Dan Castle just picked up his third. He's out. There's a steal by Clinton. And Diarra, taking Castle's place, will take it up the other way.
That's Klingon's third steal of the game.
To go with four blocks, 14 points, and 10 rebounds.
It's Diarra. Newton, Klingon thrashing his way inside.
That's the UConn ball movement. You get down the court quickly, you make a couple of passes, people move, and you get somebody open inside.
It's in the corner. Gibbs Wahorn will take it. That's another block shot. Klingon's got five. He's playing tennis.
Come on.
Spencer.
I mean, you've got the dish to Hawkins wide open there.
Hillaband with a three. Shannon, Hawkins, bring out Klingon, pop it a three, rebound taken by Cam Spencer, Klingon running, oh, knocked away by Hawkins. Foul goes on Hawkins, but we know the offense of UConn is number one. They're also in the top 10 in defense, number six nationally.
And look at the numbers in the NCAA tournament. All their defensive numbers have improved. And Illinois, they're getting some open shots. Now, that last one wasn't necessarily a good one. He was way far out, and he tried to do it off the dribble. But, boy, if you're going to shoot those, you better make those, because those long misses allows UConn to get out and go.
Klingon at the line. Danger will come in. Hawkins will sit. Klingon wears number 32 to honor his late mother, who died of breast cancer 6 years ago. She wore number 32 as one of the best players in the history of the University of Maine. So good they retired her number. Klingon will check out. He has been a one-man wrecking crew with a look at the late Stacy Klingon. Number 32. And, of course, number 32 has great significance in UConn history, worn by Rip Hamilton, now retired. Klingon will be the last to wear it. Dancing is shot. Rejected inside. Samson Johnson. Here they go. Johnson in there. Twirls and scores.
Wow. We have seen now both big guys block shots, run the floor, and score at the other end.
The only surprise there was Johnson didn't dunk it.
Nothing Connecticut run. Goody, three. Rebound picked up by Newton. 16 straight misses. Hillaband inside. The dunk, the foul. Count it. And he hung on the rim for safety.
You take those threes, you're going to get long rebounds, and Caravan does a great job. We've seen this a couple of times. He just runs out. Shannon commits the foul, and you're right, Kevin. Caravan would have really been hurt had he not hung on there.
And Shannon comes under him, and Shannon picks up the foul. That's the second on him.
Well, when the ball is shot from the top, the shooter's not going to be able to get back against a guy running out. Your guys up on the wings have to rotate back. This has been a total collapse on the part of Illinois.
How often have you seen a 28-0 run?
I mean, we're six and a half minutes into the half, and it's 23-0 just in this half.
But the hard thing to imagine is it was tied at 23.
They average 84. Inside bumped was Marcus Damask as he was taking it in. The Big Ten newcomer of the year. Foul goes on Samson Johnson.
And not only do they average 84 points a game on the year, but since February 1st, they've averaged more than 87. This is an excellent offensive team in Illinois, but they just can't get anything going.
And Goody throws it away. Spencer Diarra.
The second inbounds pass that Goody has thrown away here We need a different inbounder. It's a 30-0 run. 30-0 against the number 10 team in the United States.
It's the mess. Inside and a shove and a foul. And it's going to go on Tristan Newton. And it is his second. UConn is the first reigning national champion to make it past the Sweet 16 to the Elite Eight since Florida did it back in 2007. Now they're 13 minutes away from going back to the Final Four. Danger into Johnson. Caravan, the rebound.
We got two questions here.
Oh, Johnson from Caravan, knocked away by Danger.
Is Illinois going to score this half?
Yes. And the other way.
And
it's been 50 minutes in real time since Illinois has scored. 50 minutes.
But the second and more important question we started the broadcast with. Can anyone compete with UConn, let alone beat them? Is there anyone out there who can even make a game competitive with them?
Newton will take it in. Hatcheting his way. Lost inside. And a foul. Shannon was defending, and Terrence Shannon will pick up the foul. Terrence Shannon tonight has three personal fouls. Shannon's got 2 points, and he's 1 of 9. And here you see defending national champs to reach the Final Four the following season. It has been 17 years.
Stan, the answer to your second question is Illinois showed you the formula in the first half, at least defensively. I mean, they held Connecticut to 28 points. Connecticut shot the ball very poorly. Illinois was pretty good defensively. But if you're going to hold Connecticut to 28 points in the first half, you have to get a lead because they're coming at you.
Wow, this has been overwhelming.
That's the word.
Guerrier for Danger. Tristan Newton back at the line.
Well, when Illinois is going to get outscored by 11 at the free throw line, that's a problem.
Well, they shoot an awful lot of free throws.
Not tonight.
No.
Look at the shooting in the second half. It's almost, you got to just rub your eyes. Shannon with the three. Wales, airball. Out of bounds. Saved. Out of bounds. And it's Illinois' ball. Shannon, 1 of 10.
Now they're 0 for 8 on 3-point shooting in the second half are the Illini.
This is an Illinois team. We've talked about their offense, but they also, they came in winners of 10 of 11 and with the third longest active winning streak in the country.
Rebound by Jalen Stewart, who just checked off the bench. Newton the other way. Damascus on it. Hold on, Johnson! Samson Johnson!
Well, I think what we've learned today is if UConn is going to give you any opening at all, and I think they did in the first half against Illinois, you have to take advantage of it, because if you don't, they're coming.
31-point lead inside the area. Outside, Stewart, three. Rebound by Justin Harmon. Shannon drives, collides, right into the defense of Hassan Diarra. UConn has been on a roll. 11 minutes and 12 seconds from the Final Four.
Some people just know that the best rate for you is a rate based on you with Allstate. Because there are people out there who aren't you. A lot of them. And you don't drive like, whoa.
I don't want my child being raised by a robot.
Other drivers are not you.
Yes, thank you so much to all 50 of my subscribers.
Nope, definitely not you. Save with DriveWise and get a rate based on you. You're in good hands with Allstate.
The Cantina Chicken Burrito isn't just for late night. Because it keeps it light with slow-roasted shredded chicken and finely shredded purple cabbage in a freshly grilled tortilla that's not shredded. Introducing the new Cantina Chicken Burrito, only at Taco Bell.
Here's another tip from the Tool Shack, how to protect the paint.
You gotta protect your paint, especially with all that sweat flying around. Right, Shaq? What are you doing?
I'm trying not to get 3 seconds in the paint.
These are your national champions.
We'll see you in 2024.
We gotta forget about last year. It's right here, right now. Y'all ready? Yeah!
Baby, dig it. I used my Capital One Quicksilver card to get 1.5% cash back on this guide to Phoenix.
I can be your guide. Mayor gave me the key to the city for my plan days.
You know that's not a real key, right?
Yes, it is.
It's okay. We know each other from college.
What do we have here? Who wants pink zebras?
We do.
Hand it over, Chuck.
Busted.
This is a new look.
Really?
Nice, is that new?
Yep, AT&T, they gave me their best deal and my choice of plan.
I like choices.
Then Joel gets choices. The Pro-El.
Nah.
The Joel and Beads. The Tro-El. The Signature and Bead Receive. MVB. The Joel Hans Sebastian Bach.
How about the juju, Joel?
Ooh, yes.
Get our best deal on any smartphone with your choice of plan, guaranteed.
Back at the Elite Eight in Boston, the winner here will take on the winner of Clemson, Alabama. Coming up next on TBS, Dan Hurley, with his defending national champion Huskies, reached out to the last guy who had to navigate a back-to-back national championship attempt. That was Billy Donovan. And Donovan's advice said, don't make it about chasing the repeat. Stick with what you've got in your formula. Let the thing play out. And that is exactly what Dan has done. And boy, have they played out perfectly in this one. Illinois is shooting 1 of 19 in the second half. Yep, 1 of 19. That's 5% Illinois shooting in the second half. Diarra.
Kevin, we showed you, you got that Clemson-Alabama game coming up, and one of those teams is going to go to their first Final Four. That's the good news. The bad news is they're going to have to play Connecticut.
Exactly.
And let's go quickly to Andy Katz as driving inside, Andy Shannon is fouled.
Well, I was just listening to the Illinois huddle, and the assistants, Brad Underwood, they kept saying, we've got to keep fighting. We have not done this all year. Terrence Shannon was vocal. The rest of those veteran guys, they kept imploring each other, come on, we've got to fight. This is not who we are.
Illinois and their losses, and they've only had 8 of them. Illinois has not lost by double digits this season. Now think of it. All season long, and here they are. Shannon can't get the free throw to go in.
That is his first free throw attempt. Yeah. This is a guy that's in the top 5 in the country in free throw attempts at almost 9 a game.
They still only have one basket in the second half.
That's 28-3 in the second half. I mean, this is as dominant as a team can be, especially at this level.
But this is what Connecticut, that's a throwaway. Diarra let that slip away. But this is what Connecticut has done, Dan, in all 3 of these tournament games. They've won each of the games by just under 29 points a game. And look at their lead right now.
But, you know, you expect it a little bit in the early rounds. You're playing against lower seeds, a team like UConn. This is the 3rd-seeded team in the East. This team won the Big Ten tournament. They've been playing great. This is the most impressive performance we've seen by UConn yet.
UConn had a third as Hawkins hits that 3. A 30-point win against San Diego State in the national championship rematch. One of the biggest margins of wins in a Sweet 16 game in 7 years. 3 is down. Kim Spencer.
Well, he did everything there to get that shot. He came up off of the stagger, set a screen on the ball, rolled to the rim, came back off the pin down. That's a movement you were talking about early in the game, Dan, and gets an open three.
Shannon across the lane, foul called. Spencer may have tagged him. TBS is your home for Major League Baseball every Tuesday night. Tune in on April 2nd for a massive doubleheader. It's the Reds taking on the Phillies, then the Giants battling the Dodgers. It starts at 6 p.m. Eastern on TBS and streaming on Max. Foul on Spencer. It's number one on the grad transfer, Cam Spencer. Here is Shannon at the free throw line.
He's got a technical foul now?
No, I think somebody's bleeding.
Oh.
The other thing which has been impressive about UConn and the way they have traversed these last couple years.
Okay, it was technical foul.
Double, yeah, double tees.
Guys chirping at one another. Goody and Newton.
Well, now see, if he's anything like his mild-mannered uncle, Trent Green, the former NFL quarterback, he would not be out there chirping.
Well,
but maybe he's taking after his grandfather, who played offensive line in the NFL, Irv Goody.
Well, look, Kevin, we've talked a lot about decisions for Illinois. The decision to be chirping down 30 points?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
I don't know what. Yeah, I don't think you want to be talking to anybody. I can't imagine what you're saying.
Well, you're saying something to get the referee's attention.
Shannon continues not to be able to make free throws.
Just amazing.
And 7 for 14 now in the two games here in Boston.
And an outstanding free throw shooter.
He was 88%.
Yes.
Wow. One of three. Two of four, excuse me.
Well, the bottom has certainly come out of the tub here for Illinois.
Oh, knocked away.
Marcus Underwood going with a couple of guys who don't play very much, Hansberry and Moretti.
They bring in Amani Hansberry, who's a freshman from Silver Spring, Maryland, and he is number 35.
Well, that was interesting.
And they got Moretti, who is from Bologna, Italy. Here is Spencer. And he's from Davidsonville, Maryland, and he takes it inside. What a play.
He moves so well without the ball. You know, we can talk about his shooting, but he's not a spot-up shooter who just stands on the perimeter. He does such a great job of moving.
It's out to Moretti, now to Hawkins. Marcus Damask, three.
Well, Damask is 3 for 3 from three, and the rest of the team's 1 for 14. Shannon, too late, but has figured it out.
Yes.
To drive the ball and then make plays to other people.
Diarra, Moretti defends. Klingon on top. Cutting is Spencer. Here's Klingon.
That ball movement is really something. They have everybody moving, and so you have no help trying to defend that screen and roll because everybody else is moving.
You just saw Bill Klingon. Donovan's dad. Here's a drive. Hawkins trying to twist in the corner. It's Hansberry, the freshman. And out of bounds. Klingon has been sensational. The sophomore from Bristol, Connecticut, Bristol Central High School, putting on a show, as are the Huskies.
You get more with Geico, no matter what kind of fan you are.
Your perimeter's weak and your point guard's a geek.
Sick burn, Caitlin.
From the trash-talking fan to the passionate fan, even the superstitious fan.
Last time you were there, you love seat. You were not wearing that. You know this is where I always sit. You do not have popcorn.
However you fan, get more with Geico.
So what is the next big thing? Well, Galaxy believes the next big thing is you.
Me?
Yes, look at you. You're open to experiment. You open your heart.
I have a play this weekend.
And with the power of Galaxy AI, you'll open even more possibilities and open your imagination. We're putting all that power in your hands. The next big thing is you.
Everyone's hyped that Wendy's made the official hamburger of March Madness a buck.
We made the board! We made the board!
But Tyler and Toby are on another level.
Get hyped with fresh, never-frozen beef on Wendy's Dave's single for a buck, only in the app.
Introducing Milo's Rewards, the new way to unlock savings from the palm of your hand. With every purchase, all loyalty members earn points toward Milo's money. Plus, you get free gifts and free shipping. The all-new Milo's Rewards program is here. Download the app to join, earn, and save today.
I was born with wings, but psoriasis swooped in to clip them. It crushed my confidence.
But no longer will psoriasis get a piece of me.
I can love my skin again with Bimzelx.
Only Bimzelx targets and blocks IL-17A plus F to calm inflammation.
I can control my plaques and start getting myself back.
Bimzelx helps adults with moderate to severe psoriasis control plaques to deliver clearer skin fast for results that last.
I will give myself back the freedom of shorts.
Dare to wear black again from head to toe.
Most people got 100% clear skin.
Some after the first dose.
Serious side effects, including suicidal thoughts and behavior, infections, and lowered ability to fight them, liver problems, and inflammatory bowel disease have occurred. Tell your doctor if these happen or worsen, or if you've had a vaccine or plan to.
Start to get yourself back with Bimzelx.
Ask your dermatologist about Bimzelx today.
Here we sit with Illinois, 3 of 22 shooting from the floor in the second half. That is 13%. And UConn putting on a March masterpiece.
Well, this second half has really been something to behold.
And it's incredible what they've done now in their 10th straight NCAA game to be winning them that many games against the best teams in the country.
Gansbury, the freshman of three. He was the Maryland High School Player of the Year and twice the best player voted in Baltimore. And he comes off the bench to hit the three right there for Brad Underwood in Illinois.
Brad Underwood, I talked to him at practice yesterday, very high on Hansberry. Thinks he's going to be an outstanding player.
Castle's been quiet after a double. Oh! He's been quiet tonight after a double-double in the Sweet 16. But Jack hammers that one in. Hansberry down low. Back out to Hawkins, clinging in the way. Shot clock at 13.
I think UConn has more dunks this half than Illinois has baskets.
There's a drive by Shannon.
That was an impressive dunk by Castle.
Well, Castle's an impressive player, plays at both ends of the floor, always under control, very poised. And it tells you what they think of a freshman, that on this experienced team, they came in against the third leading scorer in the country. Who'd they put on Terrence Shannon? Stephon Castle.
When they were recruiting him out of Newton High School in Covington, Georgia, the thing that sold Castle on UConn was when Dan Hurley said, listen, you may have had all these individual accolades talking about Castle, but you've done nothing in terms of being on a winning team. Come to UConn and be a part of something bigger than yourself. And Castle has come back and said, that stuck.
Well, he's a winning player. Takes care of the ball, plays unselfishly, plays both ends of the floor.
And his first double-double of the season in the Sweet 16 a couple nights ago here in Boston.
And you're talking about the fact that he was on Shannon to start the game. He got in foul trouble, but Shannon certainly was not as productive as Illinois needed him to be.
Diarra! Finessing his way inside.
Well, he got himself right next to Klingon, and nobody could get around Klingon, so that's an easy basket. But again, they move, they pass. And when they attack on the dribble, they really go.
Shannon, Hansberry, freshman against freshman over Castle. It will be.
Checking back into the game for the Fighting Illini, Justin.
In Connecticut possession.
And Marcus Tillman.
And that sends you back to 1992, the last 30-plus point win in the Elite Eight. UConn has faced 12 straight elimination games and won them all. Not many teams have ever done that. 12, going back to the Big East tournament and certainly in the NCAA tournament.
That's incredible.
Yeah, 12. They're looking at number 13 right now. Diarra, 5.5 to go. Caravan. Foul called on the freshman Imani Hansberry down low with a shove as he tried to stop Klingon, which no one has done tonight. Right now, Connecticut has won 9 consecutive NCAA tournaments, all by double digit, tournament games, all by double digits. The only school to do that aside from them, 9 in a row, Michigan State. And they're the only team in that conversation by winning by 13 points or more. Klingon can't hit. 9 straight wins in the NCAA tournament, going back to last year by double digits. Hansberry 3. Another one.
Hansberry's made a couple of threes, and Shannon's approach in the second half to offense to become a creator has been outstanding. They just haven't been able to make shots, and a little too late before they got to a more intelligent approach.
Well, Hansberry has now made 2 threes. He was 2 for 10 on the season coming in.
Spencer.
How about that pass?
That was a great pass.
Well, look, Spencer, we haven't talked about a whole lot today. 11 points, 12 rebounds, 5 assists, 2 blocks, and a steal. I mean, Klingon's been dominant, but Spencer has been outstanding.
Hawkins 3. Rebound inside with a shove and a foul to go on UConn. Spencer with the 12 rebounds, new career high. He's never had more than 9. And here he's got, in the biggest game of his college career, 12. Foul on Caravan number 2. Godzilla Kong, the new empire. Experience it on the big screen and in IMAX. Now playing only in theaters. So here is Hansberry. His mom played college basketball at Howard. And when he was coming out of, when Imani was coming out of Mount St. Joseph High School, one of the top 70 players in the country, as was Klingon, when he came out of Bristol Central High School, his night may be over. 4.5 to go. Samson Johnson will come in. Caravan and Castle. Also out there, Jalen Stewart.
Yeah, they got him that time.
Yeah, they sure did.
His first turnover, and UConn only their 5th turnover of the night. They average fewer than 10 turnovers a game on the year. They now have 18 assists and 5 turnovers. They lead the nation in assist to turnover ratio at almost 2 a game, and they're over 3-1 tonight.
Shannon trying to get it down low. Guerrier is back in. Marcus Damask will take it inside. Whoop. That's a foul on Damask. And taking it and falling, Jalen Stewart. Damask has 3.
Marcus Damask. Damask shot that elbow out there. If he keeps that in, right there, and it comes out, I think if he just holds that elbow in, then he probably doesn't pick up that charge. I think you'd have to hit Stewart a little harder than that to throw him that far.
You know who Stewart's dad is, don't you? There's Caravan going to check out. Jalen Stewart's dad is Roderick, his brother Roderick. Remember they played at USC. Then overseas. It's a 3. Solo ball takes it. With a rebound, Harmon gets it on the wing. In the corner, Damask 3. No, Castle the rebound. Here goes Stewart the other way.
I mean, on top of everything else, Illinois' lack of defensive balance of getting people back on the shot has been awful in the second half.
But how aggressive has UConn been? They look for that, and if you don't get back, they really attack you.
Typical of what UConn has done tonight. 3 minutes and 33 seconds away from the Final Four.
Hello, Mia. Are you ready to meet your demise?
Man, we really need to upgrade your trash talk.
Nice shot. Shot. Taker.
Who programmed you?
I'll see you tomorrow.
The future isn't scary. Not investing in it is. 100 innovative companies, one ETF. Before investing, carefully read and consider fund investment objectives, risks, charges, expenses, and more in prospectus at Invesco.com.
Honey garlic and honey sriracha wings? I love honey.
Oh, like Winnie the Pooh?
I'm sorry, Winnie the who?
Winnie the Pooh.
Yeah, I don't know who that is. Weird last name, though. Hey, Piglet!
What's up, Hank?
You gotta try these wings.
All right.
Piglet?
Yeah, eat up, buddy.
Dad, don't forget about my new queen.
Sweetie, I can't make it to Dick's this week.
Have you heard of Dick's.com?
Have I heard of Dick's.com?
Have I heard of Dick's.com?
Whoa.
Don't overthink it. Let's go shopping.
Anyone impressed with how fast that was?
When you put on that uniform, there's a sense of pride. You're not just wearing your last name. You're representing everything that got you here. Your family. Where you're from. Wearing that uniform makes a statement that you belong to something bigger.
We've made some minor augmentations.
Rated PG-13.
Man, we can't buy a bucket.
You know what you do? Your team can't buy a bucket.
You gonna say buy a bucket of Corona, huh?
No.
Your bucket, Mr. Manning?
Oh, who ordered this?
Give me this. You think you slick. You're not slick.
I got you. Just leave it right here.
Coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Tournament is sponsored by Buffalo Wild Wings. Let's go sports bar. Dick's. Dick's believes sports have the power to change lives. The U.S. Army. Be all you can be. And by Corona Extra. Live la vida más fina.
The defending champion, the UConn Huskies, have been a number one seed before, but they're the number one overall seed for the first time in program history this year. And their coach, the fiery Dan Hurley, has got his team playing at a level that is devastatingly good.
Look, we've thrown a lot of stats at you, but in the first half, points in the paint were even, 16 apiece. In the second half, points in the paint, UConn 32, Illinois 2.
They're going after Diarra.
And I think, Stan, the point that emphasizes, UConn has only made 3 of 17 three-pointers today. They can beat you in a lot of different ways. Okay, they can make threes, but if they don't, they can just really bury you inside, and that's what they've done.
And Steve Damask. It's Terrence Shannon inside, and he's got 8. Well, the average is 23.
They had a win also where they were 3 for 22 from three in this tournament. So while they're very capable from three, they're not dependent on the three.
Damask intercepts at the other end. Harmon fouled as he fired. Stewart got him from the side.
And a lot of those 32 points inside that we're talking about in the second half have been layups, running out in transition, but a number of them have been clinging. You know, a lot of times you see that stat and you say, well, you know, is it really the big guy scoring in there? Well, today, yes, it has been clinging, scoring very effectively inside, but they've gotten so many run-out baskets.
Harmon at the free throw line.
Harmon, actually, their very first Big Ten game this year against Northwestern had 20 points.
He's a grad senior from Chicago Curry High School. Went to a junior college in Kansas, then went to Utah Valley State. Played there a couple years. They were WAC champions one of those seasons after being a city champion at Curry High School in Chicago. Here he is finishing up with the Illini. 3 minutes to go. Full court pressure by Illinois. Castle's got it. Connecticut is going to set a program record with their 35th win tonight. Doubled Diarra. With the clock ticking down. And Castle holding. Inside for Johnson. It ricochets off of his hands and out of bounds. Oh, they're going to say it's UConn. Yep. It's Illinois' ball.
I was wondering what that call was. Danny Hurley's got to get his son in the game. I mean, look, if I'm the coach, there is exactly one parent I'm worried about of any of my players.
Shannon Harmon, three. Rebound, Castle.
Uh-oh.
They've got numbers. Here comes. Oh, Hawkins got up high on ball. The solo ball was flying it off the wing.
The ball was going for spectacular there. And, you know, the UConn way is to pass it here, and instead he doesn't. That's a great block coming around behind him to not foul.
It's Diarra.
Diarra was huge in the first half.
Yes.
When they were struggling offensively, he came in and gave them a big lift. He's got 11 points off the bench.
He's played really well in both of the games at this site.
Stewart will go inside, and Samson Johnson is there. A steal, ball up, off, rebound Hawkins.
The ball is looking for the spectacular.
On the side, Guerrier, his three is good. You know, we're talking about all these players coming in for UConn. Their depth, as Jay Wright said, depth can minimize mental fatigue for a team that's got a target on their back like a national champion UConn team does. And Jay should know, he says, it can catch up with you. Teams are trying to go after you. A team trying to repeat faces that every game.
Well, when you're winning games by 25, 30 points all the time, that'll minimize mental fatigue, too. You're not in. I know they talk about baseball pitchers. It's not how many pitches you throw. It's how many high-leverage pitches you throw. UConn hasn't been in high-leverage situations late in the game.
Here comes the coach's son. And by the way, with Andrew Hurley coming in, this has been something they've been doing in big wins. And we know how there's Andrea, his mom, and the wife of Dan Hurley. Dan has said he's kind of become, he's very superstitious. The head coach of UConn is, he said, we want to get him in at the end of games because usually when we do that, it's a win. And here they are again putting him in as they get ready to pack their bags for Arizona. Rumaglu.
Well, if I'm Andrew Hurley's mom, I'm upset at the coach and I'm making my.
Ooh.
Distress known tonight. He should have been in this game earlier. I think as a parent, she should be all over the coach on this one.
Well, and she is a parent. The coach has to pay attention.
Absolutely. The only one.
Andrew Hurley. Again, is a walk-on danger in the game. Ross with the rebound. Ross, one of the best players to come out of New York. He was raised in Bristol, Virginia, with the ball right here. He's a freshman. Solomon Ball is a freshman from Leesburg, Virginia. Top 60 recruit. Here's Hurley. Samson Johnson, shot clock is at 7. Goody will defend. Good feed to Ball. Hurley the assist. I think we've said that a couple times, haven't we, over the years?
Stan, you're talking about the fact that UConn hasn't had to play like that pitcher in a baseball game in high-stress situations. Well, what did Danny Turley tell us? You know, we stink in close games, so we've decided we're going to do it in this a different way. And boy, have they.
Yeah, Golly, I mean, they were in one close game at the end that I can think of.
Well, think about this now. They're in the NCAA tournament. They have lost exactly one game in 2 years to a non-conference team. And didn't lose any last year, won this year.
We're four games into this tournament with the final four around the corner. And UConn has only trailed by 28 seconds in the entire tournament. They are coming into tonight plus 86 points through three games of the tournament, the second most ever by a reigning champion. The other one, the 1955 LaSalle national champion.
That would have been Tom Gola, maybe?
And now, look at Tom Gola. They're plus 86 coming in. And they're going to add to that right now. The clock is frozen.
Well, that's the last thing anybody wants. Yep, they're headed to the Final Four.
Program has been there six times. They've won five. This will be their seventh trip to the Final Four. There are not a lot of schools in college basketball that can say that. My goodness.
What's amazing with them, watching them through these tournament games, is they get these big leads and never let up. There's never a time where they let up. They just keep coming at you.
Shot clock violation. Illinois will get it. So Illinois inbound. The UConn Huskies are going back to the Final Four to defend their title. The number one overall seed, Connecticut, will try to become the first program to repeat as a national champion in 17 years. UConn is going back to the Final Four.
Wow.
Wow is right. Wow. What a second half performance.
I mean, we can talk about domination. That was more like decimation.
UConn has got a new program record in wins, number 35 tonight. They will take on the winner of Alabama and Clemson coming up moments from now in Los Angeles.
Can anybody give this team a competitive game, Dan?
You know, that's a very good question, and I don't know the answer to that question because, as we've said, they come at you in all sorts of different ways. I mean, they can beat you inside, they can beat you outside. They put tremendous pressure on your defense with all their movement. They're a tremendous offensive rebounding team. I think that if anybody's going to beat them, and I think there's some really good teams left in this tournament, but no matter who you are, you're going to have to play your A, maybe your A-plus game, and UConn's going to have an off night.
And UConn has had some off nights. As you said, they were 3-for-17 from three tonight. They've had a 3-for-22 game. I mean, they've had off nights.
Well, they shot 33% in the first half. They only scored 28 points. And if that happens in another game, you've got to be ahead of them 40-28. You can't be behind by